Welcome to Reasonable Ignorance, Episode 7. I am Michael Walton, a.k.a. Magic Mike 32. On your Instagram and your Twitter, my man is
Jamal Shabazz, King Bula. I don't give a fuck. That shit was hot.
And then we got some special guests in the building.
Young gunners, young G's, whatever the fuck, man.
What's your name, man?
This is Justin. Jay Gooder, Jay underscore.
Finally!
Bro, that shit wasn't staying.
Finally!
Twitter,
finally, I got Jay Gooder in the motherfucking building. That's at Jay underscore G O O D E R.
Right. I'm honored to be here.
Brutally honest.
Straight
up. That nigga's brutally honest.
I say what I want you to know.
My God, he
fuck
does.
Fuck what you asked me.
He's a young guy. Where you graduating from?
Shit. I graduated Chicago State 2007, you know.
You see that?
That's
nigga's...
my final little school career run right there.
You got that degree.
Hey, yeah. Mike, did you see that nigga just, he sniffed, like, you know.
Like, He scoffed that nigga.
Who else we got? Hey, yeah, we got Dutch in the building. Sour Dutch, Instagram and Twitter, y'all know what it is. If you don't know, you're going to know now.
So, then... check it out.
I'm the low keyest of the high keyest, though.
Wait.
I'm the low keyest of the high keyest. The most known unknown.
The low keyest of the what?
The high keyest. The most known unknown.
The low keyest of the high
keyest. The low keyest of the high keyest. Yeah, that is the statement of the fucking night right now.
Yeah.
Straight up.
How you come? You must have thought about that shit before. You came in with the dark.
No, bro. You know,
the low keyest of the high keyest?
Yeah, man. Uh-huh. You know.
That's like saying I'm the pissed off of the pistiviest and shit like that.
Yeah, I don't know what the pissed off of the pistiviest is.
Pissed off to the highest of pistiviest.
Hey, the dude say it's kicking in.
Already.
All motherfucking ready.
Check it out.
All right, man, let's get on this.
Check it out. First of all, this episode is going to be about young versus older. Wisdom versus youth. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So,
like Chris Brown.
Yeah.
Versus Bobby Brown.
And I fucks with Bobby.
And nobody did it like Bobby. Chris Wynn can't do it like Bobby.
Y'all had me listening to Don't Be Cruel.
Wait. But did Bobby get his place robbed with his aunt with a gun to his fucking aunt's head?
No, but he got his brother-in-law killed right in front of him.
Ooh.
His brother-in-law got killed, Bobby took the Rolls Royce Corniche back to the projects, and him and Whitney was doing their thing.
The Roxbury Projects in Boston.
But his brother-in-law was known to be the stick-up man.
So, how's his brother? His brother-in-law or his brother?
Brother-in-law, his sister's husband.
Whitney.
You know what I'm saying?
No,
Whitney's
sister's husband.
Bobby had Whitney's.
Bobby up.
No.
She did.
She didn't want to get him on the shit. But anyway, I'm gonna ride with Bobby all along. But listen, I'm ride with him to the end. Well, we gonna match it up and see what our disconnect came because. Like, y'all didn't even know each other, but y'all probably been at each other's head probably on Twitter before.
Shit. I seen some of this shit.
Yeah, yeah.
When you said the name, they dapped each other up. Yeah.
That's Jay Gooder. Like,
we
had to meet each other at the skating rink and, like, really get to know them.
That's true.
All the projects used to go to the skating rinks back in the day.
And we had to know motherfuckers from their school jackets.
Man, I swear I hate
them. And in the plaza.
All from off their jackets.
Like, the plaza. You're like, y'all have no evergreen plaza.
I've been to the plaza.
Like, y'all didn't go there when it was at the prime. Like, you used to have to meet a bitch by the Indian.
Oh, understand this.
Yeah, by the Indian.
Until them Simeon and them King niggas came in with their jackets and took all the bitches.
Me and Magic Mike is from the era where the projects used to take school buses to all the fucking skating rinks.
To spin the wheels.
Is that in Indiana, right? Or yeah, is that Indiana. Gary used to make money off the projects from... He used to make money off all the Robert Taylor projects and everybody else.
Yeah.
So you always... Just think about it. You had all them damn GDs in one fucking building.
Hmm. And one...
Shook. That's why I never went.
I understand.
Then you had...
I'll be out here.
Then you had...
same shit.
What's the shit out there in the Wild Hunters over there off Jeffrey? Jeffrey Manor, right?
Mm-hmm.
All the folks from out there.
Okay.
So you realize you got all the ops in one fucking building, as you young niggas say. Ops and shit. We ain't never say ops back then.
We just said hooks and...
I'm feeling to say
Yeah,
ops.
We say bricks. Yeah. I mean, yeah, we said sipes.
Watch your mouth, son.
See? Hey, watch your fucking mouth.
I feel like I'm hey, you do be disrespectful on here, bro.
Wait. Y'all to his folks, so...
Check it out. We're going to get into our intro. We changed the intro up this week.
Yeah.
For a special reason, man.
Yeah.
We went old school with Ghost. Who's from the almighty Wu-Tang Clan.
Say that again. Just say the word almighty for me. I like that. Wu-Tang Clan. No, just say it. Almighty without saying the Wu-Tang.
Wu-Tang Clan.
Say almighty.
And damn. Listen, it was 9 MCs who formed like Voltron and got in your ass. And Action Bronson is a white rapper from Queens with a beard who had the nerve to sound like Ghostface, then switch up his style, and he was on Sports Nation on ESPN, and he was talking about, they asked him a question about, they told him how he sounded like Ghostface, and he said, Ghostface not rapping like this now. They need to come out.
That was so egotistical for Action to say that, and I'm an Action Bronson fan.
I don't listen, bro.
I understand you might not. But
I never knew who he was.
That kid got flow. Yeah, he can spit.
But if you YouTube him, he sounds just like Ghost.
But hold on.
His voice is very similar.
Yeah. True, it is. And you know, and I'm a Ghostface fanatic. I feel like he's the best out of Wu-Tang anyway. But the thing about it is when it comes to Action, I like Action.
Do you
like
what you just said?
Yeah. Right.
Can go into an argument for the next 7 hours.
Yes, it can. What?
The barbershop used to go crazy with that. Like, I remember niggas used to be like, "Who's the best MC in
Wu-Tang?"
Wu-Tang.
And what was they? What was the majority?
It was like the you know, Jizza.
Raekwon.
Then it go with you know Meth.
I was gonna say that.
It go with Raekwon. And then
Ghost got the most charisma.
But I like Ghost because Ghost came with that on Triumph. And they was talking about the God body and all that.
Yeah.
But he started his voice off. He said, "Yo, fuck that. Fuck all that knowledge y'all speak. Right. We getting on this other shit." Look, that was the coldest shit ever to me. And I had to learn that nigga whole verse because he got on some wild shit.
Yeah.
My top three out of Wu-Tang is, and it will be, and I will argue with you for 7 hours straight, Ghost, Old Dirty Bastard, Method Man. Nobody can fuck with Old Dirty Bastard and that whole Wu-Tang.
You know when the first time they ever came in?
When?
Was in 93. They came here and they performed the Operation Push.
Stories.
And somebody
by Magic Mike
threw something on the stage.
It was over.
What they throw?
My man, Ghostface, took his Heineken bottle, and Roger Clemens pitched that bitch in the audience. Oh, man, do you know that place went up? All your boys over there, all them almighty guys,
all them O's, all the Lords.
Oh my God!
Yeah,
I was on the wall looking. Man, they was whooping ass. Wu-Tang was whooping ass. Everybody was with Wu-Tang was whooping ass. And guess where they went after that?
Them niggas.
They went straight to 35th. In Indiana, to a place called the Pole Woods. With a dude named Chinaman. He used to hang with a dude named Chinaman.
Chinaman.
He got killed. Rest in peace.
Oh, okay.
He got killed.
Okay.
Now when Ida B. Wells and Newtown flipped BDGD, you know, when all that.
Oh, thing. Okay.
But he had did a stint.
That's another podcast from now.
He had did a stint in New York in Rikers Island.
Uh-huh.
With I want to say it was Ray Brother, and that's how he got killed. Cool with the Wu-Tang when he was there. Okay. So when he came home, they came out, and he was their plug in.
We gonna, you know what's tripped out is?
Stories.
When you said that stories by Magic Mike. When you said that story just quick, right? And you said about with Ghost getting shit thrown at him. It reminds me of what happened on the video I saw yesterday.
J. Cole,
right? He took the iPhone.
Give J. Cole a break, man.
They threw the iPhone at J. Cole.
J. Cole, low-key, Born Sinners was cold. Now, everything else, I ain't gonna be no fanboy about. It's decent, but cut bro a break, man. everybody be hating on, bro. Man, bro, you got to get everybody who do some type of respect.
No, why would you throw an iPhone at the nigga?
Right, that's what I was just about to ask.
This is my thing. Molly. Somebody on a Molly threw it. Nobody.
It had to be an accident. Who want to throw their iPhone? You know how much the iPhone really, costs?
No. You've been in a show. You've performed before. You've been at a show. You rap. You know how it is.
I know how it is.
You've been to shows too.
At me,
you young niggas. Yeah. You young niggas. You know them white boys when they get off that fucking whatever they fucking off with. The white delegation. Okay.
All they need is beer.
They throw shit on stage. I done seen cups. The iPhone is extreme. I've never seen that shit
before. Ask Russell that. You're an innovator. We want to interview you.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
We got to bring you here. Whoever you are, we got to bring you here. Yeah. But the thing about it is, did you see it, Matt?
I didn't see it. I didn't see it.
G.
I got to look it up.
They threw out, please don't quote me on saying the word G, but they threw an iPhone at this dude's head, and they hit him upside the head. He caught it and put it in his fucking pocket.
And kept rhyming.
Pretty much.
Wow.
Wow.
I give him that.
They go through it.
Respect.
I give him that.
You feel me?
Kept going, you know what I mean?
I give him that.
You got to do what you got to do.
Ghostface is...
Dirty Sprite.
Ghostface is from me and Magic's era.
Yeah.
Action Bronson is from now, your era of hip-hop.
Y'all take the L on this.
Just
take the L, man. This is
right. Because Supreme Clientele, I was part of that. Like, Shell the Ghost came out, I was part of that. I got a feeling for that. I got a tape of that for real, for real. I took it to school.
What about the song where he talked about his girl? When she broke his heart, he just cussed out the whole song. You riding bitch, that's why I fucked you in your period. Where you was bleeding. When he went in on.
That was the first album.
Yeah, all of them.
That's why I say I'm in between. Because I ain't too familiar with
that.
That
was Iron Man, right? That was Iron Man, right?
I ain't too familiar
with that. That was Iron Man, the first album.
Yeah, the first one.
That was the first album. That was 96. That's 96 Ghostface. Y'all was like what?
See, I was a shorty then. I really ain't getting into, you know?
Right.
What was that? Domestic violence that RZA did? He was on the same shit.
Yeah.
Remember?
Yeah.
What I'm saying is,
what
high school you went to?
Kenwood.
Y'all was fake. They was bougie hip hop over there. Y'all slick shit.
I mean, you know, and what I'm get saying. Away. I did 2 years at Kenwood. The first two I did at Hales Franciscan.
Yeah. Okay,
I remember that, but I had to get up out of that, man.
So you was over there with my man,
who?
The rapper Bump J.
Oh, shit, he did go there, didn't he?
Yeah, he went to
Hells. You know
Bump.
What?
He went to Hells.
I didn't see Bump around till after, like, after high school.
When he created his whole other, when he was calling himself Chief.
The East Side Goons.
Hey, man. Free Bump, man.
Yeah, he about time he get on out of there.
Yeah.
Don't he get out of there this year or something?
Yeah, he about to come on.
Yeah, we need Bump in the city, man. We need that energy.
Yeah, you know, Bump, you feel like Bump was a good storyteller.
Bump was low-key, as far as everybody else go, I got to stop saying low-key, but Bump, to me, was kind of like Hov. Like, he gave you a good story. He gave you that drug background, that crime background, that dark feeling, and then he could still hit you with some bars that'll make you be like, yeah, and keep you entertained. That's what you want in the artist, to keep you entertained.
And he had Sly with him. Sly. I like Sly. I mean,
Sly like beans, you feel me?
Yeah.
But he can still spit. He that guy don't wanna. He indebted into the hood.
Yeah,
I give you a W on that one, cause you really laid it out well. Cause I was about to jump all over you. Like,
yeah, I know.
I'm gonna jump the right whole now. Thing,
you know what I mean? So you know how I get down.
I know how you get on.
Where I see you at? At the United Center.
Yeah.
We went to what?
We
went
to go see Ho. We went everywhere.
What row we go to? Like the third row? Fourth row?
Yeah, we was low.
To the fourth row.
I mean, you know.
No ticket. I don't do tickets. All that shit is for the fans. I ain't going there with no ticket. I have to see the person I have come to watch entertain me, who I've been listening to. I have to see that person as close as possible with no ticket. That's just the way I get out.
I'm flexing on
show. But listen,
he's flexing on y'all ass
gotta
right
tell
now.
Y'all flexing. I got to tell you something. Action Bronson fucking with the wrong person. I went to go see Wu-Tang at, remember Rock the Bells?
Yeah.
They was at Northerly Ireland.
Yeah.
And that's when my boy was
what's his name, Pharrell Munch and all them when they was out, and Nas came and did his song with them.
Yeah.
Man, some white dude in the front said, "Where's Old Dirty?" They stopped the song. They had a live band. They said, "Hold it, cut that shit off." Dude said, "What you say in my face?" He said, "Where's Old Dirty?" Man, they said, "Bring the ruckus." Man, they, everybody from behind the stage, I promise you, jumped down and whooped this man's ass. So they got the cameras there, right? Now they jumped back on the stage, and he was looking stupid as hell. He was cross-eyed, nosebleed. Guess what they said? What
did he say?
"Leave him there, man. Security don't touch him. Let him enjoy the fucking show." He wanted to see where Old Dirty Pass was at. That's where Old Dirty at. He just, we just swarmed on your ass. And they started the song over.
And you know
I
what?
I said, look at that shit.
And that motherfucker.
That's what I love about them guys.
And that motherfucker didn't even sue.
No.
He just took he took that L.
Forever.
He took that L and he talks about it to this day.
Man, right. they
not saying Mike did.
Hey, they threw him about 4 t-shirts. Because one of them, they was, like, the camera kept going on. So somebody from Wu-Tang noticed that it, like, look, they keep putting it on the Jumbotron. Dude said, "Hey, yo, man, if you put that motherfucking camera back on him, we're going to whoop your ass."
Ah.
I promise you. All I would never forget that for the rest of my life.
Okay, here's the real question,
yeah,
Mike.
Real, like, huh?
Did you sneak a hit in?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. All right.
I'm gonna tell you, we had a prominent coach with me, and when we interviewed him, I'll tell you the story. I'll tell you the story. And we didn't pay for parking or nothing. And we had some guys that he grew up with, all that. That's my Axel Foley shit.
This whole podcast was about the young thinking versus which is perceived as the old thinking, and it's like, now we have a situation where, with the Action Bronson, we're using this as an example. There's no discretion. There's no discretion with you all, with you all's generation. You all are the digital generation.
Right.
You, the cameraman, right now, the digital generation.
Shout out to Juwan, man. Back in here again with us.
And the thing about it is, it's like, you know, like me and him, we got stories buried.
Yeah.
We could tell some shit and say some shit for real, period.
Yeah.
But your generation, on down to like what, his age of 19, 17, 18, y'all don't give a fuck about nothing.
Y'all
don't give two shits about nothing.
We love y'all energy. It just
no, we don't.
They're fearless, but it goes.
We don't the wrong love their energy. You know that. Come on,
man.
Now.
I like it because it's fearlessness. You talking to a class clown. I will say anything out of my mouth.
True.
I'm before the, like, I wasn't going to get in the phone and tweet about it. I'm just going to say it.
This is the person that gave a homeless guy hot
wings, man.
Hot Harold's chicken and made everybody watch him eat that Harold's chicken full of hot sauce the south side of Chicago, and we all laughed. He said, "Woo, this shit hot. I ain't never had this shit before."
That's nothing, man. That's
that's right.
That was
see,
my favorite
you
place
see?
To be on the weekends too.
League stock. Long live league stock.
So y'all got thoughts, right?
Yeah.
You ever had?
I don't got no thoughts. I mean, I ain't got no hoes.
He's a motherfucking cool. Lie. He's a low key, high key, hot. Lie.
You can see who's
low key, high key lie.
You can see who's in a real serious relationship. He denies all
he's a fucking liar. Motherfucker. So you ain't married, you a liar.
Well, I know some hoes.
So you been in college, right?
Mm-hmm.
The young wild shit, the loose bras.
Yeah, man, like, you know, the curious white girls.
Yeah.
The girls that are from the small town that's not from actual Chicago.
You was fucking bitches from Effingham.
Yeah. Right, West Bubblefuck is this one little hood chick tried to tell me one time.
West what?
West Bubblefuck.
Yeah. What the fuck is that at?
That means way out in the burbs, country. Yeah.
West Bubblefuck. He didn't give a fuck.
He was never going there.
Exactly. Hey, if she from West Bubblefuck, I tell from Chicago.
It's just, a rap.
Right. It's just like love.
Yeah.
Love emojis everywhere, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Art emojis. Love
West
ass.
Bubblefuck.
See, y'all the emoji era. Like, we had to write art. You know, our shit. We was getting caught with the letters.
Still in school.
Writing letters and
Would you go with me? Yes or no?
And the teacher catch the letter. Like, my letter used to be like,
was it dirty? Right. Yeah. That's what I wanted to know.
Yeah, of course. Wow. It, of course, yeah. I spelled dick and pussy together.
Yeah, yeah. That's definitely
spelled correctly.
You was a pioneer.
But the other words fucked up. So the teacher be like, and you wonder why you get an F on this one. It's like we come from there. Like y'all feelings can't be hurt easily.
Like, it can be.
Like. Y'all have never y'all have never been embarrassed out openly in public. Like y'all do that. Y'all gotta get y'all revenge right back then. Like if the teacher embarrass y'all,
you gotta go right then.
You gotta bitch what you mean, you know what I'm saying? But we had to take it because they could hit us back then.
Yeah.
And y'all didn't come from that era. Like
it's like you don't want to get treated.
Yeah, like y'all got cell phones. Y'all come from the cell phone era.
True.
We had one phone in the house. And you had to sneak on the motherfucker. And your mama had one in her room. And she could pick the motherfucker up without you even hearing it and just hear you.
And just hear
it. Get off the phone, Mike!
And then she's just, no, that was super light. Like, she just said some super. Do she know you don't wash your dick? Like, shit like that. You're like, what? I gotta go, baby. And that'll be the first bitch you see at school tomorrow.
Y'all got no discretion.
And you just be like trying to duck her and shit. Because you be trying to tell her some fly shit. Like, yeah, my dick bigger than mine. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Right, right.
Your mama say, "Do she know that motherfucker ain't circumcised?" And just, like, I got to go. Wait. And you just hang up.
Right. I mean,
I ain't have to go through that little kid.
Y'all had your own phones. Y'all was texting. Y'all could text all night.
That text. Yeah.
Do you know if I had an iPhone when I was 14 years old, I would have never went to sleep at night. Never.
That's probably why we be up all day.
Yeah. You know. Yeah. We used to be on the. We'll do the group. We'll do the, what you call it, you know what I'm saying, three-way?
Yeah,
we'll
three-way. Three-way be popping.
Now, you talking about the three-way on the phone?
We get on the house phone, you know what I'm saying?
So, another girl will call you?
Nigga.
That's your day.
Do you know, a bro called me, which was a best friend. Her best friend was mad at her. Like, the chick I like, her best friend was mad at her. So she was like, look, I'm going to tell you how she be playing you. Watch this, I'm going to call her, don't say a word. The bitch told me a new ass. I was like, damn. So when she hung up, she was like, now call her. I called her, I was like, what you doing? She was like, man, just thinking about you. I said, how? How are you thinking about me, bitch? What good thoughts, I hope. And I never did forget that. I always, when somebody, somebody texts me, that'd be like, good thoughts, I hope. Because I heard a bitch talk about me like it was no tomorrow.
But
still to this day, I hope she hears this this podcast.
Because
she really knows who I'm talking about.
She knows.
You still fucking her, though?
No, I don't fuck her.
She still want to fuck her, though?
No.
I just fucked her.
I want to get my lick back, though. Right. I want her to know I'm going to get my lick back.
Right.
So when we get this podcast.
That means you're going to penis slap her, then, right?
To the heights.
You're going to penis slap her?
No, I'm
going to penis slap her.
I got something better than the penis slap. <Your penis. laughs> I got something way better than the penis slap.
I gotta ask.
I'm going to a church like Richard Pryor did on Which Way Is Up. That's what I'm with it. Like, somebody been fucking my wife. I think it's you.
Richard Pryor is the GOAT. Yeah. Now, what I want to say is, why is there no discretion? I gotta ask that shit. Why you young niggas ain't got no fucking, y'all just,
I preach this.
Y'all live for the fucking moment. Y'all live for today. Nigga told me, y'all, we live for today. We don't give a fuck about tomorrow.
You know, I feel like, you know what I'm saying, like, nothing changes more than it stays the same. You know what I'm saying? Like, I think, like, people don't change, just ideas change a little bit. I mean, like how you said, like, the young kids can't get embarrassed. Well, I mean, it was like, what's cool, you know what I'm saying, what's the right thing to do? When y'all was growing up, the right thing to do was to maybe maybe take that whooping if you're getting a fight on some one-on-one. You know what I'm saying? All violence is emasculating at the end of the day, but these kids, they can't, you know, what they want to do, they want to immediately get a gun. They ain't even lost a fight all the way. They
ain't even fought yet.
Right. You know what I'm saying? So
they didn't even get to the fight. They like, I'm finna just go blow it down real quick. Like,
but I think that's because they desensitized too.
Our
video game was space invaders. I've been numb
since I was a shorty, so I can understand how they feel.
Yeah.
I ain't even have like a bunch of bodies. It's just they getting body after body. You just be like, man, this is a shit to be me.
You understand how they feel?
Sometimes you just That's just how your mind works.
Part of me understanding is the cycle. You know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, okay, listen to like some of these, you know, the drill rappers, the Chicago rappers.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? How often they talk about, you know, pulling somebody cap back. You know what I mean? But it's like, at the same time, it's wrong. You know what I'm saying? At the same time, I also understand that it's like, you gonna shoot me, I'm gonna shoot you before you shoot me. You know, like, right. it's like they petrified. You know what I'm saying? They acting like, everybody act like they tough. You know what
but
I mean?
Really,
like,
they scared.
Right, exactly. Like, they know that I don't want to end up like Pac or Big. Exactly. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's the legacy. You know what I'm saying? Violence. So, you know what I'm saying?
How easy is it to get a gun right now? How easy?
Smooth.
Work?
It's smooth. You just gotta know the right person who got guns. You just gotta hang with what you need. If you need a certain thing, you hang around those certain type of people.
They told me today, somebody was down on 22nd Street with a motherfucking machine gun, just letting it ride.
On 22nd?
22nd.
Yeah.
It be what? Happening.
It's a machine gun.
One thing I do follow it's on, a quiet on Twitter is Spot News.
I follow on Twitter. Want to make sure they ain't just get the shoe one for to go pick
wanna,
the piece up at.
I want to know where the fuck to be and when not to
and
be.
And when not to be.
When I see police cars flying up and down, if they're flying past me, I immediately get on Spot News. Because I got to see what's really going on.
You know,
check it out.
You, with the police situation, you got, now that they can't find jobs, the vets can't find jobs, they go straight to be police. You got Marines, you got Army niggas, you got all these niggas that's been in these wars, coming home being police officers now from the services. Outside of the motherfuckers that can't get a job in real life, they go what? To the police force. So you got these crazy ass, and you got the motherfucking Klan members becoming what? Police officers. You got gang members becoming police officers. You understand what I'm saying?
But ain't nobody killing us more than us.
Than us, you heard? Yeah.
The police, I'm not really too much worried about the police, because I don't really...
I ain't gonna lie, police got me shook. I see the police, I'm old, what did I do? And I know I probably ain't did nothing, but you still never know. On my way here, I probably could've got mic'd 4 times if I just wasn't paying attention.
Yeah, that's crazy.
And they'll mic you for nothing. So
yeah, that's why I try to dress a little different. I try to represent the grown man. I don't let my pants sag. Man. I don't let my drawers show.
You don't want
to
give.
I ain't dressing like Miguel or no shit, but I'm not dressing.
You just don't want to give them a reason.
Oh, yeah.
Because they just all they thinking now is just give me a reason.
Like even, when I was
go for it.
Just they want to be like, you know, just walk a little different to make me suspect that you feel a little ways that you see me so I can pull you over.
Yeah.
I mean, but do you as the younger generation give these motherfuckers
man,
a reason
just,
to do such?
We just living, man. At the end of the day, you
okay,
got to
okay.
know what you
got to no, do. No, you say that, though. You got
a good point, though. I mean, you know what I'm saying? Like, I respect our individuality, exactly. But do these brothers really have that, you know what I'm saying?
Some people don't have no respect.
Everybody looks the same, you know what I'm saying? So, and it's like, the people who not very street smart, they go look at the brothers and how we act when we constantly shooting each other. Like he said, sagging to the knees, they sag harder than they did in the 90s.
Mm-hmm. I mean, but the thing about it is there value for black life?
No,
From you all's perspective.
It's out there. You know, it's a lot of it seems like nowadays it's a big polar opposite or whatever. Yeah. Like extreme opposite.
So,
like
so you got said the it's a clique.
You got the goons, then you got the real smart, studious, straight A's, proficient, mathematic, you know what I'm saying, knowledgeable, everything, you know what I'm saying? Like, you don't really have the in-between. Like that's why I think I noticed about the young kids. Like, they either just thugging it out completely.
Or
they just about to go to NASA or something. Yeah. You know
but,
what I'm saying?
But,
or they're...
Yeah.
Well, those are the ones that we got to worry about.
They be lit, too, though. It's like...
That's what I'm saying. I seen a video
where a dude mopped a girl up, and I felt so bad for Shorty, because it's like, even though you do what you do, bro, like, that's still a female. You got to be a... Excuse me, that's still a woman. You gotta be a little bit more respectful towards a woman because you're a man at the end of the day.
And I'm sorry, y'all. I was talking about the gays. You know, nothing against the gays.
Nothing
I'm just saying,
against
like,
them, but
it's like everybody's like
They well, go the, extreme.
I think what y'all trying to say is everybody is just like, if you're not my bro, I ain't really fuck with you. So that's the answer to Jamal's, you know, question about is there respect for black life.
I mean,
everybody wants to jump on the case when they say the police.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But why, where's the outcry but then for the
Capo,
four bodies?
When Capo killed dude, got killed, mm-hmm. when he got killed, sorry about that.
Please clear that
when
up.
Capo got clear killed and Chief Keith wouldn't come here, we had Father Michael Flather.
He got too much. I don't want to really speak on that, but
speak. Oh
time,
no!
Listen, man.
This is your platform to
this
speak.
This is what I say. See, I understand.
Don't
what
censor
he's doing,
yourself at all.
But and I understand what Chief Keep doing. It's really both. Do you want to deal the devil you know or the devil you don't know? That's kind of how the situation. Who really is? You rather deal with Chief Keep, who out here speaking upon things that people look like
the low guy on the totem pole for the murders.
It's exactly it's Chief
because
Keef.
he's
they
not,
putting the blame
he doesn't,
on
he, does, he doesn't make the guns. He didn't say shit about Charlton Heston.
Exactly.
Charlton Heston, the one who played Moses in the Ten Commandments.
Can you?
Yeah. Who's the head of the National Rifle
exactly.
Association?
Can you?
Say,
can you honestly?
So you know why he has a gun? If you don't need, I don't need a gun because I don't take shit from nobody.
Can you honestly?
When you taking shit from people, you need a gun.
You need a gun.
Can you honestly?
They gonna come back and get their shit. Mm-hmm. So that's why Charlton Heston, the guy that played Moses, needs a gun because he's been taking shit his whole life and he's not giving up his gun. Nobody calls mm-hmm. him out.
I seen him with his Mike hands Flager, up in the gun.
Mike Flager, you called out the wrong guy.
But at the same time, Magic, Just, and Dutch, can you honestly say that you want to watch a hologram concert? And I'm not anti-Chief Keef.
I don't think the numbers would have been there.
Can you honestly? Yes, it would have.
It would have been there. So
if the numbers would have been there.
They should have let them do it. The people would have came.
The numbers would have came.
That's just something to be a part of. You got to look at this. How I look at life. If it's anything you can Instagram, people going to make it. Yeah.
Can you honestly sit up here and say that if he performed I Don't Like, the original version, not the remix, when he said, I'm smoking on Tuckapack, which is dissing everybody that lived on 62nd and St. Lawrence, 63rd St. Lawrence, because that's where Tucker was from.
Right.
If he performs that record at a charity situation concert for the Capo and the baby that got killed,
yeah.
Can you live with that? Can you live with that? All three of y'all, can y'all live with that? Honestly.
Honestly, you know why I say I can live with it? Because
he ain't pulled
a trick. I'm not saying that. It's the situation.
Smoking on Tuckapack.
He's playing the cards that he was dealt. He's not. I'm sure he's not the same person he was before I Don't Like. Or, you know, when he made them lyrics. He has money now. You know, they're looking at a different guy, and he's going to have different direction. When you're coming from Parkway Gardens that has nothing, and you're eating, waking up in the morning, eating Flaming Hots with cheese, and you're going to bed eating Flaming Hots and cheese. I mean, you angry. You know what I mean? So you and your guys finally get one good spade in your hand, and it walks. You finally get the King of Spades, and you get one song, one hit, and you out of there. I mean, Dirt, Reese, them three guys took about a good 140 guys out of the projects. Parkway Gardens.
But you cannot
say. But they was raised on violence. Since they've been on this earth, they've been raised on violence. They never got a good hand.
Okay. They might not have. But you're talking about a hologram concert for Stop the Violence charity. And I'm all for it. I will.
One thing about it, we'll never know because
they do it all the time.
They canceled it all the time.
They say put your guns down and play a song dealing with guns all the time. Yeah. Why does this time matter? They do it all the time. It happens all the time. You can't stop what it is.
Yeah. Where are they getting the guns from? How can a kid get a gun from an AK-47? A gun is made in Russia. And he's never been far east as the lakefront. Ask, I mean, answer that question. How can a kid that's given nothing in life get his hands on a 30 shot gun. A 30 shot.
Come off the motherfucking trains that they get worried about.
So how
come off the train? Them trains take up everything.
So how
they take them off them trains?
Why they don't have money on them trains then? Why they don't have TVs? That's something is good for everybody on there.
Okay.
Why don't have something that's good for everybody on there? In that community.
Honestly.
Why not?
They do have everything that's good. Niggas robbed a train. I mean, honestly.
Yeah.
Niggas robbed. Nigga, that's a lick that's got to hit. Now. Right now, you got a nine-year-old supposedly between 9 and 15, 13 years old. Little kid, black child, down in Memphis, toting guns in his video.
Nine?
Baby CEO.
Now it's swag though. Now it's trend. So now
it's trendy.
Now you got to look at it like
baby CEO.
Hey, I'm gonna
that
just
kid.
Be,
is, did you see the video?
You have to look at it like
you
this.
Are a
everything
rapper.
Everything gets younger and younger and younger and younger. You, sex got younger and younger and younger. Violence gonna get younger and younger and younger. It's gonna go from where you see 7-year-olds carrying joints because
it's
at the end of the day, another 7-year-old got a joint.
It's comical
for entertainment, but in real life, it's real. If
that,
another 7-year-old got the joint, you gotta have a joint. You 7.
That's
two.
Nothing. There's nothing comical about a kid toting a 30.
You know, when things are bad,
you talking about
in Memphis?
Funny, you know, things that's bad. You always look back on bad things and laugh. I mean, it's not funny at all. A 9-year-old. Promote violence, but at the same time, it's like when you talk about it itself, you know, I was just like, what? 9 years old? Like, I almost laughed a little bit myself. I didn't mean like, oh, you know,
you
I got a good laugh out of it, but it's like, what? You know what I'm saying?
Just, are you desensitized to it?
You know what? I'm definitely desensitized, you know, but this has been going on long before our generation, I feel like, you know, but you know what I'm saying?
So you say you blame us.
Exactly, like I definitely do. You know what I'm saying? Like what you just told me about, you know what I'm saying, not to put it all on you, but you said the hot sauce, the homeless fellow.
Yeah.
All right, let's rewind that for a second. That ain't really no different from what all these youngins doing. Only difference is they got an iPhone in front of it. Mm-hmm. They're gonna record it, so now it looks like it looks a little worse because you're recording it. You look a little bit more, you look less sensitive or considerate or whatnot. But
he was feeding that nigga. Quit bullshitting.
But the thing
true
is,
true that. But what they gonna do? What the internet sensitive people gonna do? And what they gonna say? Oh, he's wrong, and he's making.
I used to get it all the time in the barbershop. I used to get it all the time. I used to smack the man. I used to do all type of
we
shit.
Talk about Big Brother.
Yeah, exactly. But so it's just
it's Big Brother.
It's there's different things
at the same time.
Hey, so hold on,
Big Brother though.
Big Brother was a pimp.
At the same time, he took care of Big Brother.
Big Brother was a pimp though.
But they don't really know, and they have no.
Wait. Big Brother was a pimp. Tell the truth about Big Brother.
He'll get money out of you all the time.
Big Brother was a pimp. No, Big Brother, before he fell in deep into his drug habit.
What are you talking about?
Big Brother was a pimp.
Oh, the lady preyed on women. She used to hate to see him coming because he used to keep a trench coat on with a sawed-off shotgun on the front of him. And he used to shoot dice. And he used to rob all the dice games. If he went up to the dice game and he had some money, he didn't have no money, he was sticking it up.
Side note, we are drinking Puffy Juice and Douce. We give back to the black community.
Yeah.
Young and old.
I want my brothers to win.
Who you calling old?
Us, we the OGs. I'm accepting that.
I thought you were speaking.
You know what I'm saying?
That's,
so Diddy?
Oh, yeah. Let's talk about Diddy. Now, Diddy amazes me. Like, okay, like that man. Look at what he did. Y'all see the award show when he brought Cassie?
Yeah.
Y'all see, like, okay, Cassie was.
You like Cassie, don't you?
Now, she always looked.
You
good
fuck Cassie.
She always looked good to me, but now.
You fucking wouldn't you? You fucking wouldn't you?
She look like money now, bro.
Answer the
question.
She looks like money now.
You fucking wouldn't you?
Of course. Come on now.
You dog walked that pussy, wouldn't you?
Cool,
smack that motherfucker. That nigga's fucking lying.
Okay.
You fucking.
Hey, look. Cassie got thicker.
At this
you got thicker, bro.
Would you say?
But hold on.
The libations have kicked in.
Yeah, they have. Would Justin, Jay Gooder, at Twitter, get that, Penis slap that bitch. My fault, excuse me. Penis slap that bitch.
Hey, come on, man. Hey, you know, like, that's already understood. But my point is.
You fuck a lady from West Fuck, Illinois.
West Bubble Fuck.
West Bubble Fuck.
Yeah, that is
the key word, people.
Yeah, man. And she hit my guy, too. So it's like, you know what I'm saying? They for everybody. Yeah. But see, you know, that's another thing. It's like, you know what I'm saying? Like, so far, it's like, you know what I'm saying? The women, too, you know what I'm saying? Like, nobody cares anymore. I agree with you on that. Yeah. But like, you got dudes like, dude, you saw what Sanaa Lathan, right? You know what I'm saying?
Sanaa is with
Rich Montana on.
Yes.
Oh, man.
Yes. That was hot.
This is who we learning from, though. What do you know what I'm saying?
What do you do?
Okay, my fault. Magic, I want you to understand this. I got to set this up for you. Diddy posted on Instagram yesterday of him driving, listening to some music. French Montana in the passenger seat with Sanaa Lathan. Daughter of Stan Lathan, the powerful industry. Love and basketball, Sanaa Lathan. Sanaa Lathan, yes.
Yeah. The one that did the box.
She was on French Montana fucking lap. French Montana. Coke Boys, baby.
So I'm going to go to my man's song right now. I'm going to refer to his song. What's my man's name? Juicy J.
Yeah. These hoes,
they for everybody.
Hey, yeah, I don't even know who originally.
Wait. But how you gonna be that at 40 something?
Huh? I mean, they.
Can you be a hoe at 40 something?
Yeah, man, she got money. You could be a hoe forever.
Y'all ask why we desensitized.
Man, when you used to die, she was fucking No.
This is why.
Wait. Stop. You done brought it up now. That's the new version of motherfucking Bobby Brown. Ray J.
Is he winning platinum? No. Does he have a platinum hit?
No.
Can he have a tour?
Wait. You tripped it.
He's never toured.
I Hit It First was kind of good. That was kind of a decent song.
That shit was decent.
I did it
over. I was in Florida listening to that shit.
Number one. It ain't go platinum.
So Bobby had 5 number one
platinum
singles.
Platinum that guy. Don't Be Cruel. I'm telling you, after I listened to your episode, I was singing that shit in the car.
Yeah, so.
Hold on.
I'm trying to tell you.
Ray J never went platinum like that, but that motherfucker is paid.
Only thing he had, that's because of the what age you always say?
What
age is this?
The digital age. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right, that's the only reason why. He made Kim Kardashian who she is because of the tape.
But did he reap the benefits from that?
No. But he the man. You not going to reap the benefits. You the man. And you the man. You wrong. Period. The woman, she misguided.
Yeah.
She can bounce back. As the man, you going to take the fall.
Because
you planned that out.
Only person still ripping.
Look what happened with Mimi.
Get me on camera doing this face.
I'm telling you.
I had to get on the mic and say that shit.
I'm saying, when you the man, you going to take the fall.
Get his face right there, Juwan.
The only person still reaping the benefits from this is Caitlyn Jenner.
Kris Jenner
is reaping the benefits of every fucking thing off Ray J. Kris Jenner, the motherfucking mammy that's 65, 64 years old. Yes, the liquor's kicking in. Libations.
And a lady told me I was wrong for the way I thought. I said, so how can I be wrong? Because this is in the barbershop. She said he could be allowed to do what he wants. I said, but you just said he looked nice. And I said,
Wait, who looked nice?
Caitlyn Jenner.
No, I just.
Bruce Jenner.
No, it's not you.
No.
The lady in the barbershop.
The lady in the barbershop
said what?
That Caitlyn Jenner looks nice. I said, she looks like Bea Arthur from The Golden Girls.
I'm sorry, I don't mean to cut you off. Mm-hmm. You mean to tell me a woman in the shop said Serena was ugly?
She didn't say she was ugly.
Okay.
She was just upset at the fact that all the men was oohing and ahhing. And it wasn't because she was
over who?
Serena Williams.
Okay.
But she said she was proud of the fact what Bruce Jenner did was brave.
Let me know when the next time she had the motherfucking barbershop.
So the baby, he gonna come in there. He's gonna have his kids.
I'm gonna let her know how I feel. I didn't watch it. When she came up, I turned the ESPYs off.
Give a 25-minute speech.
Too long.
Way too long.
Way too long. But you know what?
That shit is longer than when the president addresses the nation.
Pretty much.
You know what I'm saying?
That's y'all.
This it's is business. The entertainment industry.
You feel me? It's business. That's all. It's business.
Yeah.
Everything you see on TV is business. You don't gonna keep care.
You all are desensitized to everything.
It's business. It's now. Not desensitized, it's that they forcing it upon us. We have no choice.
Yeah.
You have to, if you watch TV, you're gonna see that. If you listen to music, you're going to hear it.
You know
I listen to ESPN 1000. I'm hearing about Caitlyn Jenner on ESPN 1000. Hey, trying to get my Bulls update. Derrick Rose, my favorite player. I'm trying to find out what's going on with the man.
Derrick Rose, your favorite player?
Favorite player.
Favorite player.
Favorite player.
Why
right
you
now.
Why ain't that Adidas song?
Because I don't fuck with Adidas. That's not, that ain't got shit to do with Derrick Rose.
Fuck all that. If Derrick Rose is your favorite player.
If Derrick Rose is in some Nikes. He'll have 4 MVPs and 4 championships right now.
Some bullshit.
I promise you.
He's a 3-striper.
No. And that's where he went wrong. Everything else he did in life is correct.
I would
that's another podcast.
I wouldn't tell you why he loved Adidas.
Hey,
I'm pretty sure it's a deep back end story to that. Yeah. And I respect
all
that.
All bullshit aside, that's some bullshit you said.
What?
But we'll talk about that later. I'm finna take a motherfucking cocktail drink for that shit.
But I mean, at the same time, we ain't desensitized. It's just business. We a little bit more... We know what's going on.
Right.
We know now because we got the internet. We can look on our phone and see all this business.
Are we just
Caitlyn Jenner everywhere? That's business. That's we know she getting a check.
That is desensitive
for kids. Young. I hate for kids under me to see that. I hate for a 7-year-old to see that. A 10-year-old to see that because they gonna think that's normal once they get older. But once they get older, it's gonna be normal.
So that's
I promise you.
That is why.
That's society.
So that's the stuff of reproduction, man. That's another plan, and that's the way above.
It's in the
thinking of the people that's just watching it. So they just watching
exactly.
it.
They just watching it.
They don't get it like
they don't get it.
Just like with the same sex can marry. You cannot reproduce, and even the Bible will tell you that. It's about procreation.
I always thought it was about procreation.
Yeah. You know, and that's why I don't mess with the Catholics, because the priest can't even get done, and it tells you that you should procreate. The Bible tells you that. So the thing is, and I want to address a lot of these Reverend Chicken Wings out here, too. They would like to tell you what they want to tell you, because they know what our women are going through, and they know what we're going through. So they pick. They preach to the woman, because they know the woman going to go to church. And she's, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we watching football and fantasy football.
Hey, long as a man don't really get in the church till you know he about to die. See, but 56 years old.
He going through something. His mama got
on him.
Yeah.
He done settled down with long chairs.
He done fell the fuck off about to go to the Fed penitentiary for the next rest of his life. That's you know what I'm saying?
On a brick.
But a man...
Wait. You said what? Oh, he done fell off. No, not before that. Before that, you said something about you better go to jail, right?
Yeah, but he done fell off. You know what I'm saying? He done saved the police one too many times and he about to do about 20 years. So now he want to get saved.
Yeah.
But that's when he started getting to the Lord, right?
Each one began
with some bad news.
Every last one of us can really peep some shit when it's not right. Mm-hmm. We know when a preacher not preaching to us, when he's preaching to the woman, mm-hmm. and he's talking about her kids and this and that. I seen Meeks do it. Him and that fucked up mustache. I done seen Corey Brooks and telling somebody being on their roof to get a building tore down. Do me a favor, man. Just go tell the motherfucker down. All that begging shit, why we got a bed? You know what I mean?
I'm tired of seeing...
What's the other dude's name?
Niggas.
He got caught buck naked with a toothbrush.
Tired of seeing niggas beg. I'm tired of seeing...
Give him a skill,
man. I'm tired of seeing kids on the street dancing. I'm tired of seeing niggas beg, period.
Hey, y'all remember them Jobs or L shirts? Y'all remember them?
Yeah.
Hey... They warned us, though. Shit been fucked up ever since them shirts. Like, they was wearing them shirts for, like, a whole year. And then, ever since then, Trayvon Martin, all this bullshit been happening. I noticed these niggas start wearing them shirts. They tried to warn us.
Jobs or else.
In 2009.
I've never seen that.
Yes, low end. Jobs it was all on the low end. Jobs or else.
That's when they was trying to get the money to help
tear down the projects.
Okay. Okay.
And so they wanted, you know, like it was a guy that he was trying to get some money, but they paid him off, so he just shut up and he told everybody he ain't gonna hire nobody.
I mean, you know, the whole premise of this conversation is young versus old. And we both generations, I'm Generation X, he's Generation X. You are the millennial generation.
Did y'all know what Generation X stands for?
What does that stand for? I heard it before. I can't even tell.
They just think straight.
Bottle Phantom was always wanted one. Get the fuck out of there with that
shit, nigga.
Hey, I like Future.
Shout out to Future. Man.
I like Future. Too. On certain songs.
Man, Future is...
Future ain't shit, and he know he ain't shit. That's why I like him, man.
Future's same age as y'all. What Future the fuck you talking about?
Bro.
That nigga served his auntie that raw. Like, he came up from the streets, no morals, and he trying to make something. He trying to be a better person, you know what
Do
saying?
You think that nigga y'all really does activists and
hell games? Yeah, boy.
You said what?
Yes.
I'm asking both of y'all. You said yes.
I'm asking you.
What happened? Do you think he does activists or lean and Zans and perks and all that kind of shit like that?
That's a good question.
I'm looking for the
perks. That's really a good question.
You and do
I,
perks?
No, I don't do them. But
you done Zans?
I did a Zan before. It wasn't really shit. I really wasn't fucking with it.
You did the Molly?
No, I don't fuck with Molly.
You done Molly?
No.
Be honest.
420, man.
Be honest.
I'm like, I'm on that weird shit. Like, I just need...
You just smoke.
420 is what I...
Yeah.
Dabs?
My love. Weed and liquor. What? Smoke weed, drink liquor.
Okay. So...
My man.
But we in this era, though, where lean, Molly, Zans, Perks is... That era of
it's
music,
just drug, prescription drug,
and niggas ain't never did that shit before.
Hey, I'm gonna tell y'all where it all started.
Where it started?
Y'all remember this song called "Party Like a Rockstar"?
Yeah. Totally.
Ever since then, skateboards, mohawks, skull belts, skull shirts, pills, every type of drug.
Let me tell you,
we assimilated, we took on the white man's style. Yeah. We was always about, we always had our own style till that came out. And after that era came out, it's like niggas just started being like, whatever, I'm gonna do what they do because they can function off that shit.
Jay Gooden. You feel me? But I want to be on perks or crack. You feel me?
Jay Gooden, let me tell you.
I see what crack do.
Let me tell you a quick story.
Y'all
ever decided to just serve the crack to buy all the motherfucking prescription drugs?
Yeah,
so that's crazy. That's
man,
that's,
I had a
like,
bike
like you still an addict though. You know what I'm saying?
Quick story. Remember?
I almost died off the lean two times. Resurrected in the act.
Okay, I didn't know
Tell me that. Talk about that.
Alright, so
yellow.
Wait.
That red or that yellow?
Say what you want.
Wait. Quick story. He brought up the, you remember we saw them at the retreat?
What was going on?
Remember he said, party like a rock star? We saw them at the retreat?
Yeah, true.
What retreat was y'all at?
Caught some DJs.
We was at
the dudes who made that song.
Yeah, they was there. They had it turnt.
They had it turnt.
Well, we was at the,
We was in Atlanta.
The spot and it was all the group dancing and shit?
Yeah, sir.
Oh, man. I don't know what you're talking about. It was lit.
I want y'all to know, understand, me and Dutch got history. Bottom line. And pause. And the thing about it is, he is an artist, he is a rap nigga. He does this shit, for real. He saw, when Jay Gooder brought up about Party Like a Rockstar, he brought up about that lifestyle and what them niggas is nowhere now. You can't even think about who them niggas is. Do you know, Juwan, do you know who them Party Like a Rockstar niggas is?
I remember the song, but I don't know nothing about that.
Right. The song was bigger than them. Dutch saw them perform live in person. I saw it myself. And the thing about it is, you don't know who them motherfuckers is right now.
It was like, to me, it looked like an expression of freedom. I felt like everybody was losing themselves. They was with that, everybody was living in the moment. So right now, at this point, everybody really, the younger generation, our mindset is living the moment because we might die tomorrow.
From 2006 up until now?
If I'm honest to God,
2007 up until now?
You might die tomorrow, so you have to live for today. That's probably why we, the way we is.
Y'all only go back as Tupac and Biggie, that's it.
Hey, Mohawks. Ever since niggas started rocking Mohawks, yeah, shit ain't never been the same, Jay. Yeah. Ever.
Another statement. So you say right now, we got, so far, Magic Mike, on Reasonable Ignorance, podcast, episode 7. We got Low Key High Key.
Right.
As a statement.
Right.
And what was that again, Jay Gooder?
I said, shit ain't never been the same ever since niggas started wearing Mohawks.
Who introduced Mohawks to the black community?
Puffy.
Motherfucking right, nigga. Okay. So yes, sir.
So Puffy.
What I just said about Puffy, though. When I said, this is who we learning from.
This whole podcast.
Sitting on the,
Puff Daddy. Puff Daddy, I am Diddy. This podcast dedicated to your motherfucking black ass. Mm-hmm.
Damn.
It's your motherfucking fault these kids where they are.
Not Wayne, Diddy.
We gotta talk about Wayne. Oh my God!
We thought it was Wayne, but it was Diddy. It's Diddy after all.
Good. We gotta talk about JG. We gotta talk about Wayne.
Wayne got a drink.
Birdman disrespectful for that. At the end of the day, that's still gonna make if things work out, you're gonna make money off of him.
He's pissed.
Like father, like son.
Hey, that nigga's pissed.
Like father, like son.
You don't diss me in front of no motherfucking Liv. Hey, you don't sit up and say fuck Cash Money in front of Liv.
Hey, if that's what you're doing,
at a motherfucking Jim Jones party, who the fuck is Jim Jones?
If Wayne Nobody. Is taking
you fuck with Jim Jones? Y'all two niggas fuck with Jim Jones?
Jim Jones has some hits. Hey.
Wait. He said no.
Hey, that's cool. He ain't got to listen to Jim Jones. I'm talking about me, bro.
Jim Jones had one hit, nigga.
He had a mixtape, though, that was crazy.
You talking about the American Gangster?
Yeah.
he had a couple good. Of tracks on there, yeah, but I mean, he had Max B in his corner.
He was waving.
Yeah, he need Max B. I rock with Max B.
Now, how you going to tell me to get
you rock with Max B?
No
yeah, I liked his little wavy Crockett and all that. Like, I like Max B, man. I feel like Future might have been listening to some Max B.
Yeah, true. Straight up. Future Low Key might be Max B reincarnated.
Hey, look, Magic Mike.
Yo.
We come from the era of Big Daddy Kane. And
we come from the era. LA. If you had a CD out or a tape or an album, you listen to the whole thing. Like Heavy D, a fat nigga that was light skinned. Like you seen the movie
when he said,
you know what I'm saying?
Overweight lover in the house.
Like Heavy D, like he fat.
Put that camera on.
He fat.
Overweight lover in the house.
You know what I'm saying? Do we look like Heavy D? Like nah, he don't look like Heavy D, but he can rap. You know what I'm saying? Biggie helped turn it around, but. We come from, like, when is the last
Yo, Juwan, you ever heard of Heavy D?
Whole CD.
You ever heard of Heavy D, Juwan?
Yeah.
The Blueprint.
Huh?
Yeah, I heard of him.
Okay.
Jay-Z, Blueprint my favorite 3? Rapper. I gotta always say that. No disrespect to nobody else, but Jay-Z low-key
but you, but,
set the trend. Let me tell you how I started rapping. I thought Tupac didn't write his own raps, because I heard Mariah Carey write songs.
Uh-huh.
I mean, I heard somebody was writing her songs. So I'm like, if somebody writing her songs, who writing Pac shit? And Pac was my favorite rapper at that time. That's how I'm like, I'm gonna write Pac shit for him. I wanted to write Pac raps.
That's crazy.
I wanted to write Pac raps. Cause he was my favorite rapper. I'm like, if somebody I can write for Pac, I want to write Pac raps. Pac was my favorite rapper. He got me started. Is. Straight up. Mm-hmm. And I don't give him much respect now just because he dissed Jay-Z who was whole. But at the same time, Pop was the guy.
But look,
y'all was 9 years old when he dissed him, though.
Yeah, still, you're right. I was about 10 years old when Pop died.
86 or 87?
I born in 84.
Okay. So you was like
10. What? I was like 10. Like
10?
I was like
no,
10,
no, no,
11,
no, 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 no. You was 12.
Nobody in this room was a bigger Pop fan than me. That's the first person
I'm a Biggie fan.
Smoke with.
Ooh.
I'm a Biggie fan.
Tupac Shakur in front of the Renaissance Hotel at the Freaknik in 95.
What?
You don't believe me? That's my man Kevin Rice. Rice, listen to this, man.
Rice, what's up, baby?
You can tell
what's up, Rice?
The whole story. You say, Mike, there go your man. Pop, I was like, who? He was like, man, get over here. I was like, who you talking about? He was like, man, your boy Pop. You gotta come over there. We get to talking shit. We sit down. He gutting the blunts.
Yeah, got the blunts.
The Philly. Rolling.
I love blunts then.
Philly's under
it. Philly blunts. So they was trying to film him like this here, because Terminator X was making a video.
Uh-huh.
And he said, man, get the goddamn cameras off me, man. Y'all know I already got 13 cases. Get that shit off of me. And he had on Fila shit. So back then, it wasn't
Fila.
Like right now, y'all could walk down the street and roll a blunt.
Blunt.
Like it's a fucking kite or something.
I wouldn't try.
I'm ad-libbing this nigga.
Now, man.
I wouldn't try.
I promise to God, we sat out there for about 40 minutes. And this is like 1:30 in the morning, man. Boy. Talking shit, bullshitting around. No bullshit. But guess who else was out there cracking jokes till about 4 o'clock in the morning with us?
Who?
Eddie Griffin. Eddie Griffin was the first person to say two of my favorite comics at the time was gay. And one of them, they like best friends, but he said he was gay.
Talking about Eddie.
Hey,
that's what y'all mean by no discretion.
Yeah.
Straight up.
I mean, you know, we can't disclose
like,
that.
Like y'all ain't never.
Because
y'all,
that never this is discretionary. Like that,
man. Yeah.
Like, y'all protect y'all people. Boy.
They talk about that on Twitter. They be like, man, bring back the Freak Nick. And then, like, I remember I was a little kid growing up in the Natty. He said, like, man, the Freak Nick, they be outside having sex and all that.
We did it.
On the back of an open bed truck, man.
Yeah.
Two dudes, two ladies, riding past, music bumping that down south Luke shit, pop that coochie.
Pop that pussy.
And they fucking.
All my favorite women.
They not twerking like how they are now, though. They weren't twerking back then like how they are now.
No, they not twerking because.
They were doing Dino back then.
But they was just. It was really like
was
something special to see
popping,
nice body ass lady. Pop that coochie.
Yeah.
That's
hey,
what
they
had the box, you had to call in to see the video.
They could write their name with their ass cheeks now. Nah, they so fucking skilled with that shit.
So if a nigga threw liquor on you, what you gonna do?
Threw liquor on me?
It's squad. Like you gotta fight. Like at the end of the day, that's how you gotta look at it. Somebody recording that shit.
Wayne looked the other way.
Right, that too.
Wayne looked the other way.
He respected his OG.
You know, it's interesting, man. Like I guess it's like, okay, let's say one of their riders or something. Like he don't know what to do. He like, man, I ride for Wayne. I ride for Baby. So I don't know. It's like it gets interesting right there. But like, it's a man or some man to man shit.
Yeah,
Wayne should have ran up on him and like no,
he was up in the
you don't throw no drink on me like I'm cheating on you or something.
He threw two drinks on.
That's how you know
that. You saw the video.
I wonder about them guys, man.
Yeah,
who throws drinks?
He was in the balcony too, so he couldn't really run up on him at that time.
Yeah. Man, I would have threw my microphone up there. Something.
I'd have did something. Some
yeah,
I'd have said something up there.
You ain't
gonna throw
shit at me. I'm ready that motherfucker. Not this.
And he want to fight dirty. You fight dirty, right?
Out the park.
Man, you're not doing no shit like that to me.
No.
But a lot of things don't get, you know, we come from a different era, but we come from the same streets of Chicago. We wear Chicago across our chest, across our back, and it's on our mind at all times, no matter where we at. When you was in school in Carbondale, I know you was like, nigga, I'm from Chicago. I don't give a fuck what you.
Where you from?
Whatever you think about me. You could be from the smallest, quietest block in the most sanctified house in the area. But when you got to put your G out, you're going to put your G out.
Yeah.
They're going to think that had to be Larry Hoover's son right there. That's Jeff Ward himself right there.
Because
we're going to bring up every gang, and we're going to bring you on our mom. We're going to hit our punch our fists. That's just Chicago right there. And there's nothing else you can do about it. Like when you take us there, he could be the quietest dude in the room. But if he got to really pull out his shit, he gonna pull out his shit. Might be from 79th place.
Mike, I gotta ask.
That nigga get through the E for the king of 79th Street.
Mike, I gotta ask these young guys.
Go ahead.
These young guys now got an app where the young lady got to sign the app to consent to sex.
the application.
It's called the application? That'd have been dope as shit if it was called the application.
But it's an app for, you know, on the phone. So my thing is, like, even y'all going too far.
Even if I don't need it, I kind of low-key now feel like I need it.
Wait.
Just.
Okay, I know about the dating sites, but what?
It's an app. Not Plenty of Fish. Mm-mm. It's an app where you sign consent that I want to fuck you tonight. Pause. I'm not going to fuck you at all.
She going to do the Dino.
Right.
And she consented to it.
Yeah.
So from that point on, she pretty much yours.
See, you see what your generation's coming up with? Me and his generation.
If you sign for $1, you going.
This the double OG right here. Mm-hmm. Understand that, Jay.
It's double OG.
I'm coming into OG status.
If she let you put the rubber on, it was good.
Right.
That's the only thing we had to worry about.
You two, that's when I started. You two gotta work, gotta have a consent, gotta have a signature, gotta have a gift, and gotta have money to keep her motherfucking mouth shut. You saw what happened to Tiger. You see what's happening right now to Cosby. What the fuck y'all gonna do right now? Is the app gonna protect y'all?
Man, hey, you know, like the old school.
Is the app gonna protect you?
You know, I used to say the old school, like, show your ID. Show me your ID.
Show you
for the hey. Show me how old you are, and we good. You know what I'm saying?
Rap niggas right now are getting shown ID. Rap niggas are taking phones. Mm-hmm. The security is taking phones.
I kind of want to take phones sometimes.
You gotta take phones.
Mm-hmm. New chicks, I
yeah, strippers just told me don't record it out of them.
New like, chicks, I want to take phones. Like, I don't trust.
You see what happened?
And I'm broke.
And now you gotta check for motherfucking next. Because you see what happened to James Harden, right?
You low-key got to kind of grab the crotch. And then at the end, about the time you get to grabbing the crotch, you can call the case.
So y'all got to finger fuck before y'all can even...
Hey,
yes.
My homie one time in the club.
Wait.
Technology.
What'd you say, Magic Mike?
They got the finger fuck before they even get to, before they even get to the number.
My man's
bitch in the club while I'm giving you this drink. And I got to put my finger up in your pussy.
True story.
Up in a motherfucking box.
That's strong, bro.
I
feel sorry for y'all.
It's like this is space age pimping. Like A-Ball MJG. Like they talked about it, but we really like living that shit now. You know what I'm saying? So. You see how it is out here, like...
You said A-Ball MJ.
Awesome.
I'm frowning at you right now.
That's
frowning.
Cool, bro. That's cool. Fat boy from the mound.
So you born in 88?
80, I'm 87. Once I got a tame and a hole, it was over for me.
Wait. He been down south.
I went hole, bleak. Oh, you went down south. Okay,
he been cool, down south. Bro. So,
Like, look, I remember listening to Pimps. And I remember, like, kind of soaking that shit up, you know what I'm saying? Like, look at it now, you got, you know what I'm saying? Like, no disrespect to Drake, because I rock with Drake.
Hey,
you know
disrespect Drake.
You got Drake, but then you had the A-Ball MJG era. I mean, you know what I'm saying? Like, so far as the consent and all the technology, I mean, all it is just technology, man. Like, I feel like ain't nothing really changed, you know what I mean? Like, the girls now... They get came at from so many directions, you know what I'm saying? Like, they don't even know who to focus on. Yeah. They on IG, they got these dudes messaging them 1,000 a day. A lot of girls complain to me talking about niggas be creeping them out. Yeah. They be jumping right into the sex.
So we go back to Jay again. Too many bitches stuck up from too many sexual advances.
Huh?
Yeah. You jump with a Jay-Z quote.
Yeah, hey, that's real, though.
Yeah.
Too many bitches stuck up from too many sexual advances. Yeah. No question. Jay-Z got too many answers.
They say back in the day, a dude get a girl number and he was in there, right?
Yeah.
Well, now you get a number, you ain't necessarily in there.
You ain't in there because you gotta take shorty out to eat.
She might not even answer your phone call. She might not answer your text.
I'm not gonna lie, I just got a chick number the other day. Shorty ain't even hit me back.
How much you spend on the day before?
It kind of depends. It depends on who it is. Some chicks you might bond with them real quick. You might get up, so she might just be cool with, you know, going somewhere to continue to bond.
You might have the right loud pack.
Mike,
so listen.
Mike.
He dodged the fucking question.
How much you just spent, nigga?
He Gail says that. Listen, let me tell you something. Y'all can get investigated so much quicker now. Like, when we was in high school,
yes, sir.
You might know a chick, get her number, Then you could ask around, like, what school she go to. Then you might ask a few people, like, you know so-and-so, you know so-and-so.
I got like follow, so.
But now y'all got Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, so they can just investigate y'all and be like, oh, go through all y'all.
You know I don't put saying? No pictures up. I ain't really
they can go through all that shit, but like,
I don't put a lot of pictures up. And my tweets ratchet as hell. Like, I bash my hoes all the time. But they're the girls I actually fuck with. So it's cool. You
yeah.
Feel? And they don't follow me. I hope they never follow me because
so
I might lose.
So many false pretenses.
They follow you. They see what you say.
You got to be correct with it.
They like it, though.
But I tell them, practice discretion.
So how many of y'all is knocked off of the social media sites?
I ain't
we keeping it all the way real, huh?
I ain't did none of them.
He's a motherfucking liar. You're a fucking liar.
Nah, man.
I know when you're lying, nigga.
Jay Gooden,
know you for
Jay Gooden don't answer that. I already know that.
I know you've been lying.
Yeah, yeah, the
I know you've been lying.
100. I ain't did none. I don't be trying to do nothing. I mean, you be cool or whatever. But at the same time, you don't really be like, you can't throw yourself up there because a chick will screenshot you so fast.
Yeah.
You got to be like, oh, wait a minute, you tried to play me out.
This is what
I got threatened over Twitter the other day, and I didn't know how to react to it. I attack first?
I feel like, all right, when you out in the world, the club, walking to Walmart, whatever, it's like, you holler at them. But it's like, with this social media stuff, I mean, you know what I'm saying, you put yourself out there, you holler at whoever, you know what I'm saying, you're interested in. Don't hold back. But a lot of that is like you getting chose with the social media stuff. Like, it's like reverse. Like, the women, they get at you. Mm. They send you a message or you speak your mind, they respect it, then they say something to you. I mean, it's not like I spend all my time trying to drive on chicks on social media. Like, no, like, just let them come to you, man. Because all it's going to do is in the end is make you look like, oh, you thirsty, trying to holler at every girl. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, if you chilling, let them come to you, man.
My thing is, for people, period, out there, how you trying to J down on somebody seriously through what they saying? Because once you get on the other side of that, it might not be that, you feel? You
gotta just like the Street Fighter commercial. The dude come up from England, from Paris,
yeah,
or whatever.
Yeah.
She's like, where you find out about that motherfucker on the internet?
Exactly. You gotta be precautious.
And he's a big old Polish guy from around the corner.
So about he's
from
France.
Yeah.
You gotta be precautious.
Y'all have a different.
Motherfuckers got funny tweets, but.
They could be funny as hell, but their phone bill.
They could be funny as hell, but I was seeing some shit the other day. You know, chicks, they like to go in on each other. Like, bitch, your motherfucking bed on the floor. You feel me?
That's crazy. And it do be on the floor.
It be on the floor.
So
that'd be up some pussy.
But that'd be the five box though.
All right. Okay. Crazy. Air mattress.
So let me talk. Get out of there. Oh, yeah.
Let's talk about that.
Get a quarter.
Out of there.
Yeah.
And shake all your clothes like a motherfucker.
Let's talk about
that. Right, you should.
Leave your draw. Like, you can add a bitch.
Yeah.
Is the threesome dead?
The threesome's gonna whack them because girls be wanting to do that shit now.
Yeah, a lot of these girls now, I think it's like that bisexual, like, some of them are just doing it to be cool, you know what I'm saying? Like, I done kicked it with chicks in LA, like, we on some truth or dare, like, man, y'all kiss each other, and they be like, all right, they kiss, they not really, you know what I'm saying? Then you got,
It's the TC thing, I call it the Trinity Curious thing.
Yeah, they
You got a lot of bitches out here that's just real dominant
stop!
Chicks, though.
I gotta say this, stop! We got a third quote. Say it again, Mike.
It's the TC thing, man. Trendy Curious.
We got low key, high key. Just what you got? You remember?
Hell no.
Yeah.
I don't remember either. What'd you say?
I said the TC thing, man. The Trendy Curious thing.
Go ahead.
And that's what and it is.
I said. Shit ain't been the same ever since. Niggas start walking Mohawks.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yeah,
that nigga ain't remember. That nigga remember that shit.
What about? He said
that's because I'm drinking. I ain't smoking. I can remember a little bit. Yeah.
Cheers.
And what else you expect from a guy that got his degree and went to Carbondale, Illinois?
Hey,
party, man.
Hey,
salute. I know.
Yeah.
All my friends went to Carbondale down there.
Yeah, baby.
None of them motherfuckers graduated.
I graduated though, baby. Yes.
You went down there?
Yeah.
I'm just the only one. Cause I'm the only one. all the other guys that went down there, I'm not going to call y'all names. I'm not going to put y'all out like that.
Discretion.
Yeah.
But listen, listen, man.
I went down there, baby.
I'd have shot it all my homies.
And he pledged.
Yeah, I pledged. Sigma, Phi Beta Sigma, the greatest fraternity ever, blue and white, yeah. But let's get back on what we're talking about.
Look at him. He's like, I don't want to disrespect my
click. Yeah. Hey, I got a click.
He plays way many years after me.
Wait.
I played in fifth grade, nigga. I was like, shit.
As soon as you came outside.
The street fraternity.
No, my buddy got whooped. I promise to God, my buddy got whooped. At lunch, he was a vice lord. He had transferred in, so we was cool. We used to little hoop, you know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
Recess and shit. And I was like, oh, he good. You know, we gonna fuck around. A week later, he was like, he a vice lord. We gonna whoop his ass. No, he cool, man. What y'all gotta whoop him for? Man.
Mike is the original OG.
I was bushing around.
Respect him.
I promise you, with a great friend of mine still to this day, Donnay Allen, we bushing around. We was talking shit, because I always had the line with the ladies. Always had the line with the ladies. You gotta, that's the way you get your chicks. You don't hit the chick with all the friend, with all the juice with the friends. You hit the one, you befriend her, and hit all the friends like that, all right?
Yeah, you did.
You don't hit the chick with all the juice. You befriend her. And make sure you cool with her on all bases. Like even at home base, first, second,
you just got
third.
Games.
Right. And sometimes when you get a foul ball, she might get it for you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I know a little bit about what
you know
about.
You know what the foul ball is?
What?
The big chick with the good credit.
You know, the I kind of figured you as I was something.
The big
all,
chick.
All the lines. Yeah.
So I was messing around with her.
Hey,
so
hey.
So my man.
Hey, hold on. Fetch. Slow down.
Moving on. He was mad as hell moving at this time.
Slow down.
Man, I gotta tell y'all, man.
You're not real until you hit some fat chick pussy.
I hit a fat chick. She low key. She told me down. Okay.
Yeah, she did. She took your motherfucking ass down, didn't she?
Every time you say low key, that means he really wanna tell you this. So tell it.
My soul that day.
Tell it.
Nah, that's it.
Tell it.
Nah, she just got a nigga soul. That was cool.
How many times she came?
I don't know.
Over you?
I don't count them up.
You came two, didn't you?
I was she young. Came, I was paying attention to me.
That bitch came three. Excuse me. Gonna have to blurt that out. That bitch came motherfucking three
I
times.
I chick, I promise to God, she knew where every nice restaurant in the city was.
So I was just telling
her. I shot to play her like.
Back to the question when you was.
Wait, stop.
You I never would go with a slice. She'd just be like, just order me this and bring it. Man, I used to have to like bullshit around at the shop. It'd be there late night or anything. No bullshit. I never did, I got you.
Justin?
I never did hit a nut. What you say now about
big,
the story?
Big girl?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, you have.
Remember when we was down at Illinois State, right?
Yeah.
With the big girl where I got drunk as hell.
Yeah.
And shorty tried to take it from me in the back of your truck.
Right.
And then y'all let me jump in the car with them other chicks, and I ended up at the hotel.
Yeah.
That was probably as close as I got to a real big girl ever.
You hit.
Nah,
you
I was trying to get some time from shorty.
You got raped.
Almost got raped, but I don't believe
it. Word to Bill Cox.
Shorty tried to take it from a nigga. She called us down. She was on some, I got a show for you to do. Come down here and perform. I'm going to interview all of that.
You should have hit her.
No.
See, this is
I was too drunk, bro. I couldn't do that.
You should have hit her.
I was too drunk.
I was gonna
throw up, bro. I can't.
Man, you should have let her hit you.
You want to hit something. It's just, all right. That's bro, just bad.
If you would have seen her, boy, you'd have been disgusted. Shorty looked like straight up, just a straight Pikachu type of character.
What's the movie with Shallow Al?
Shallow Al. It was Shallow Al. She was
shorty. Big ass panties. She probably
would have shorty. No disrespect.
Put you in between
but
the panties and slingshotted your ass back to Chicago.
No disrespect, but.
Hey, look.
You're not disrespecting. This bitch needs to get a blast fitness. You
this is
you gotta be PC all around, huh?
There's such a thing as a practice chick. You never had a practice chick before?
Yeah.
That's that chick.
You never had a practice chick before.
That's that chick that know every Bible verse, every Christian song. They talk about nothing but the Lord on Facebook.
Say
she wants to call you over at least at about 1:30 at night when a kid sleep.
Experience.
And she gonna tear you down at the front door, and that's all she want. Then she gonna give you a
period
to go outside with too, cause she.
I ain't getting no.
But you can't think you the only one. She can cook and everything. Like she know everything.
You gotta know she thotty.
She knows it, but she gonna pray for you. You call her when you get in the jam. She like.
He is talking from
trust
what?
Me.
Yeah.
Experience.
Like, I ain't never had one of them.
She gonna tear you down like yeah, you're not gonna hit no skins at all. She just gonna knock you down.
Many guys don't love you how they supposed to.
Hey, if you never hit a fat chick,
y'all don't have that.
You ain't a real man.
And this ain't a fat chick.
Women these days don't love you how they supposed to, bro.
Cause y'all,
huh?
They want you. They want. They be chicks these days to be like, what you bring to the table? And when you ain't even built no table, like, bitch, we ain't even went out to eat yet.
So let me tell y'all.
Is that true? Hold on, Jay Gooden. What he just said. Say it again.
They want you to bring something to the table, but they don't even have nothing themselves.
Jay Good, is that true?
I mean, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not going to say everybody. You
not,
know what
I'm saying? Everybody.
No, wait. No. If you say, matter of fact, if you say one person, that means it's true.
No.
Jay Good, is it true?
2 minutes, I'm going to give y'all something like quick.
Jay Good, is it true? Hold on, Mike. Is it true, Jay Good?
I mean, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, I think, like, a lot of these chicks, like, they get their idea off, like, Twitter, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
Like, how it's supposed to go down with their little standards, you know what I'm saying? Like, they, like,
so,
they.
So that's what I was trying to tell y'all. They don't have the nourishment. That y'all era and the era up under y'all, you're missing nourishment. So, like, the kid in the suburb, whose mother is working 12 hours a day and whose father's working 15 hours a day, they missing their fathers. They missing their mothers. So what do they have in front of them all the time? A computer, a video game, a tablet, an iPhone, or Android. So they don't know how it's really supposed to go. So what you say? They get it off of Twitter. You get other people's thoughts in you, so you don't miss that nourishment. Same thing with the ghetto. The ghetto is missing the same thing, like in Parkway, by someone about Chief Keef. He didn't get it because him and his guys, they damn near raised each other.
Mm-hmm.
So you go off of your friends. So that's what the same shit is for the so y'all, that's why y'all so fearless, because y'all really don't know. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. We got it because we had to go to school. We was made to go to school. I wasn't in seventh grade talking about I'm not going to school today. Mm-hmm. I was ready to go to church.
Right.
I had to go to church every day, you know what I'm saying? So that taught us discipline, that taught us action, that taught us how to mingle, how to talk, how to socialize in person.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what y'all missing. Hey, man, I hope y'all enjoyed this segment, man. Episode 7 of Reasonable Doubt, man. Magic Mike 32, man. We appreciate y'all.
Did you say Reasonable Doubt?
Reasonable Ignorance, man.
Reasonable ignorance. This nigga got Jay-Z on his mind. Reasonable Ignorance.
Shaboy!
It's episode 7. Young G versus the OGs.
Names?
Jamal Shabazz.
J_Gooder.
Sour
Dutch, man.
Sour
Dutch. Y'all check us out on
Magic
Instagram.
Magic Mike 32.
On Instagram and Twitter, man.
We are here.
And Juwan, we appreciate you, man.
Yes, sir.
And I'm proud of you guys. I want to say that quick. I'm proud of y'all. Real talk.
Jake,
I was on your ass about getting this shit done.
Yeah.
You got the perfect partner in crime.
Shout out to Mac.
Hey, I've been with both of y'all. For years, for decades and shit, over 10 years.
He was scared.
I know he was.
Shout out to my nigga Jay Gooder for coming through. I appreciate it.
Man, I
love you, little
too, bro.
Straight up.
Word is bomb. We're going to do part two. Come up in August.
Okay.
We're going to do part two. I want you back.
Indeed.
Sour Dutch, I want you back.
I'm going to try to get me some ass. And my,
Jay Wan, hope you learned something, young nigga.
Yes, sir.
Young boy, I hope you learned something. And with that being said,
we done.
We out. Reasonable Ignorance.
That's a wrap.
Episode 7. Cross.